The look of love is in your eyes.
Hi guys, and tonight I'm going to be doing a video on 60s style makeup. As you can see, I have done one eye in the 60s style makeup, and I'll be doing the other one. See the difference in my eyes? Got a small eye and that eye looks massive. Okay, so I'm going to begin by putting on again the dark brown Rimmel. Can you see that? Just over the lid, very close to the lashes. So here I go, over the lashes, right, just to there like that. Okay. And then what I'm going to do next is on the bottom, on your waterline, I'm going to go underneath. But you need to take this slightly away from your bottom lashes so that you get a wider eye effect, okay? So bring it round. And when you get to nearly the corner of your eye, you need to bring it slightly out and down. If you watch what I'm doing. Okay, so can you see? Two. Yeah? Right, that creates what is a template for you to go over it in the black liner, which again I'm using Rimmel Black, just plain jet black, to go over what I've done in the brown. And you literally just go to the outer corner of your eye with this. You see what I've done? Yep. All cool? Brilliant stuff. Right. Now what you need to do is you need to go back to your brown, your Rimmel dark brown, and you need to do a template for your socket line, which will start around here. And you draw a nice big socket line into your socket, and you draw it to the ends about there, okay? So just slightly longer than the line on your lashes, and slightly thicken it towards the end, okay? Right, then you go over that in the black. I know it seems a lot, but you need to do this because it will hold your liquid liner a lot better. Any mistakes, get your nail, give it a tweak. See, I've gone over that in the black. Okay, maybe take that out a little longer. Give it a little tweak. Okay, yeah, that's looking relatively okay, right? So then you're left with what looks like this. Okay, right, now what you need to do is you need to take your concealer, and I use, as before, the Panstick, Max Factor Panstick, like even, in Fair. Just take a little bit of that on your finger and just put it into the way you've just drawn your line. Any mistakes, just get your pencil, dab it over. Then what you need to do is take an eyeshadow, and the one that I am using is in, it's Rimmel, and it is in Moonlight Shadow, okay? I've gone blurry. Oh, I'm back. So you get this Moonlight Shadow and you press in right to the corner of the socket line and the line that you did with the on close to the lashes. Don't worry if you go over your line, because you can always go back in with that from the socket line. But you need to get this quite heavy and really bright. Take it all the way along, and as you can see, I've actually gone over the line there. So just get your black eye pencil again if this happens, and literally just go back over what you've done there. It won't make a difference. Right, see? So you're then left with something that looks like that. Okay? Then what you need to do is take your black again and go along your waterline over the template of brown that you've done and bring it nearer to the corner of your eye. But not, don't do it in such a way that you go, don't draw right up to your corner of your eye, draw it slightly away from the corner of your eye so that you're left with like that, okay? Bring it out slightly. So you're left with that kind of a look. Right, so you're left with that kind of a look, okay? And then what you need to do is you need to go into your liquid liner. I'm using, today, I'm using Rimmel Scandalize in Jet Black, which is like that. And it's a pencil liner. Well, no, it's a liquid liner, but it's in like a pencil. You can see it's like a felt tip. So you need to take this, or whatever liquid eyeliner you use, and go along that line. Bringing it out. And then do exactly the same along the lash line. Okay, and then what you need to do, so you're left with, hang on, excuse my stupid camera, I need to get a new one. So then you're kind of left with this kind of look. And then what you need to do is you need to go along, I look like a witch on here. Anyway, what you need to do is take this again and you need to get in focus. And then you need to go along the line that you've done with your pencil with your liquid. All the way down to your left with. Okay? Right, and then what I do after that is I take Ivory Coast again. Oh, good gracious. It's by 17. And it's Ivory Coast. So then you press on over the top of that, your Ivory Coast. Right. You don't have to go too crazy with that because you don't want it to outshine your white. And then you need to take a slightly angled brush. I don't know the names of these brushes because they literally are in a tool roll. And it's slightly angled. Can you see? Slanting off, and then I'm going to use again this palette, and I'm going to use the dark charcoal again to slightly smudge the socket line. So here we go, bear with me, okay? So you just literally dab it on and you smudge that slightly out of the line, going down. Just to soften a little bit. You don't want too much of a softness. The 60s look was rather hard and harsh, but that's the way it was. It looked fantastic, so you need to just go and soften that slightly till you're looking at a soft but hard line. So then you're left with voila. Okay. Then what I do now is I take some fake eyelashes. Bear with me while I grab them. You need actually three pieces of eyelashes. I will show you what I'm going to do now. The first one I'm going to put on is just a regular size eyelash over the lash line. And again, this eyelash glue is brilliant. There's never any drama or anything. I'm so used to doing it on that side. You take your eyelash and you don't place it so close to the lashes, you just slightly away from. So, and then you push up. As in the last tutorial, hold and blow into the position you want. Right, so then you're left with a little heavier. Then you take an even heavier lash, which is a real thick one, like that. Grab your glue, pop that on along the lash line. That's right. And then you take this one and you pop it on top of the other one. Again, blow and hold and position as you blow. Almost like you're molding it into place. So you are then left with the heavy eyelashes and the heavy eyelids. Now the next thing I do, I know it's rather random, but I take a tiny piece of lash. You can buy these separately, or you can take a strip from your lashes that you've already bought and cut them. And it's a tiny little piece about that size for the bottom of your lash. So then you grab the glue again, whack a bit on, da 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 da. Not too much, because you don't want it, because this glue is actually excellent stuff. Now, you put this, hang on, excuse this, I need to get this sorted out totally. Oh, pants. Sorry, guys. Right, so I will then need to position it just outside the line that you have done and blow. So can you see? So now you are left with massive eyes. And then if you wish to, with whichever powder you use or anything, I mean, I use Rimmel Stay Matte in transparent, as you know, 0101, just to go over the foundation that you've done, just to give it a little extra zhuzh. And then your lipstick, your best bet, I find, is Kate Moss Rimmel in 101. And it's in a very, very pale pink. Now I'm going to use a lip brush for this to put some of this on, and just pale as you like, whack some of that on. because it's all about the eyes in the 60s look. Lips were very, very neutral. Very, very pale. So that's the look I use for the lips. And if it's not pale enough, take some white eyeshadow of any kind and just to highlight slightly. Or if you've got an even paler, you might even have a paler lipstick for me. I don't really have a pale, that much of a pale lipstick on me. Just to pale that up a little bit. Blush wise, you just, I would recommend a peachy colour. Sorry, there again. And we're back. Up there, like that. Hair wise, and that's basically the makeup look. So let's get you a better angle on this. That's the 60s makeup look. It's kind of heavy and kind of crazy, but it's a great look if you go into a fancy dress party, or even if you like to wear this day to day, you know, you might even want to wear this day to day. The hair, you can do several styles. You can have the beehive up like that, or you can have like this with the headband. You can wear any color headband, whatever you want. You can wear pigtails, Brigitte Bardot-y. I mean, you can wear, I mean, anything. Anything goes with this 60s look if you want to do it. Just look at the styles that there were in them days and put your hair to it. But for the eyes, that's my tutorial. And you saw the difference from the beginning to the end. I mean, the difference is astounding, really, isn't it? I mean, they look massive, and I've got the tiniest eyes in the world. But that's it. That's my tutorial, guys, on the 60s look. And I hope you've liked it. I'm really sorry for the blurring out. I will catch you again soon. And don't forget to have a good look through Life Reviews and Vintage News. Have a great evening, folks. Catch you soon. Bye.